Breaking news in New Jersey. Senate President Stephen Sweeney has been pushing to pass Senate Bill S2173, which was pulled from being voted on because there were not enough votes to support it. Afterwards, he said, "They can cheer all they want. This bill is going to get done. This is good public policy." Sweeney has been put on notice by political boss George Norcross, the de facto leader of New Jersey, as they are under pressure to get this law passed. Sweeney has been trying to influence senators who planned on voting no and is offering them future support in elections through a super PAC called General Majority, which is run by Norcross, in exchange for their vote. What he didn't expect is the voice of so many New Jersey residents to be heard and who showed up at the Senate hearing to support the First Amendment and the freedom of religious exemptions. So why is Sweeney trying to buy votes? We did an investigation on Sweeney and Norcross, and this is what we found. The story actually goes back to the two of them being childhood friends. George Norcross became successful, but he knew he had to stay out of politics if he wanted to keep his insurance contracts private. So he convinced Steve to become a politician, but Norcross calls the shots when he needs something done. So Norcross runs an insurance firm called Connor, Strong, and Buckaloo, which has worked with townships and municipal authorities for over 30 years. And Norcross has used his firm to build a tremendous amount of political connections for his quid pro quo operation. Connor Strong and Buckaloo also works with a multitude of pharmaceutical companies across the nation in research and development of vaccines, human clinical trials, product recall, and integrative risk programs. The information on a majority of those clients is private. Recently, the pressure has been put on Norcross, who is currently under investigation for committing fraud against the New Jersey Economic Development Authority, the NJEDA, where a multitude of companies he is affiliated with, including Connor Strong and Buckaloo, Cooper University, and Holtec, which holds board positions, and then Teva Pharmaceuticals, all had millions in tax incentives frozen due to fraud. Teva Pharmaceuticals just settled a $23 billion case as a main plaintiff in the opioid epidemic, and they were also found guilty of price-fixing prescription drugs. This company also is in the business of vaccines, yet they are receiving tax incentives from our state. Sweeney and former Governor Christie appointed the majority of the board members for the NJEDA, who then helped push Norcross and his affiliates through the process of approval, winning them millions in tax incentives. Governor Phil Murphy recently formed a task force to investigate this corruption, which also involves Philip Norcross, George's brother, whose law firm helped craft the legislation for the tax incentives. The investigation is still in the process, and Murphy just removed the majority of the board members, even though Sweeney was adamant they stay on. Norcross and Sweeney are also connected to Saul Bearer, chairman of Teva Pharmaceuticals, which is another company under investigation for the tax incentives fraud. Saul Bearer was also appointed by Christie and Sweeney to a special board that attempted a hostile takeover of Rutgers Camden, which would have given control over to Cooper University. The bill failed due to the protest, but that didn't stop Sweeney from abolishing the Board of Trustees at Rutgers Camden as payback. And that's our report for today. Stay classy, Norcross and Sweeney. See you next time.